Hey guys, what's going on? Happy Monday morning. It's 8 a.m. I post my daily videos every day at 8 a.m. Eastern time. Before I get into this video, make sure you like, subscribe, comment below. These are actually, I enjoy doing these little videos about, you know, basically advice and how I view things. So let me get into this video. So cashing out too soon in the market in particular, because that's obviously what my channel is about. It's about individual stock picking, and I see this happen a lot, and some people PM me, some people comment, or like people that I just talk about in the market, they'll get into it, and what they'll do is they'll like get up a little bit and then they'll sell. But like you ask them why they sold, and they're like, well, I made some money. Like, but that's really not the right mindset when you want to like have long-term wealth basically. So it's really just not what you want to do. So with that said, don't always take profits. Let's just say, for example, at like 10 to 30%, let's just say you buy a stock, like the market's been hot the past year, right? Let's just say you bought a stock in December, and then by January, you're up 10% or 30% on a position. Well, if you really like the company and you believe in it long-term, why would you take profits at that, you know, percentage? I mean, yeah, you're up, but you know, wouldn't you rather potentially 10x it or 2x it or 5x it, like whatever the company is, if you really believe in it, you shouldn't be getting out of it that soon. So that's something you really shouldn't do if you believe in companies. Like as a long-term investor, you really just don't want to do that. Also, another thing is if you do cash out of a position at 10%, 30%, or just say you hold a position for a couple of years and you're like, okay, I want to put that money into something else, make sure you reinvest it. That's really something a lot of people don't do. So once you take profit out of, you know, a stock, make sure you reinvest it into another one. Don't go out and buy the newest iPhone, the newest shoes, and like a car. So that basically puts you back at zero once you buy all those things. It, you know, really what you want to do is you want to compound it. So really compounding wealth is the way how you get really, 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 really wealthy in life. It's my opinion. So try not buying things. Try, if you do sell something, make sure you reinvest it back into your, you know, the market. Long-term investing with good companies. So that's really the trick, and that's what I really preach. I like finding good companies, primarily growth companies, that have really good long-term opportunities. So if you buy a good company, it doesn't really matter what they do in the short term. You really just want to focus on, okay, is this company going to grow in the next, you know, do 3 to 5 year visions, right? Because anything more than 5 years is really kind of hard to predict where the company's going direction-wise. But when you buy a company, if you like everything you see about them, you like the CEO, you like their balance sheet, you like their products, you like the direction they're going, you like that their industry might have a lot of growth in the future, you know, there's no reason to, you know, really sell it for a while. And then that way, you know, you don't really have to worry about the short-term thing. So that's something that I look at when I invest in something. Another thing is you want to stay disciplined. So really it's like a mindset you need to have. You can't get caught up on the day-to-day things or the week-to-week or even month-to-month. A lot of times companies might have, you know, if the market has a downward trend for a little bit, okay, you got to just like stay disciplined, not panic and say, I'm in it for the long term. It's going to turn around. This is just a buying opportunity. So it's really something you got to, you know, really focus on and really teach your mind how to stay disciplined. You also don't want to, you know, let's just say you have a routine, like me example, I put X amount of dollars in the market every month, no matter what. If that requires me not to go out to a dinner once a week, or if that requires me not to buy new shoes, if I don't really need them or a new phone, you know, that's kind of the mindset I do. I want to put X amount in the market every month, no matter what. That's like one of my top priorities every month to do, no matter what. Anything that can wait will wait. So it's kind of a, you just need to stay disciplined and be consistent with it. So if you play around with like a compound calculator, it will blow your mind what, you know, if let's just say, for example, I wish I started doing it at this age, but let's just say you were 18 or 20 years old and you started out with $0 and you were like, okay, I'm going to save $400 to $500 a week. If you're not, you know, if you have a job, right? It doesn't have to be a high paying job. If you can just put $400 away a month, which is like a mediocre average car payment. Like if you buy a car for $24,000, you're gonna pay $400 a month, easy, probably more, $500. If you just somehow save that save that money, right? And put it in the market. If you did that year over year for 25 years, if you had a 15% year over year growth, which is very doable if you individual stock picking good companies, I guarantee you probably have somewhere $2.5 to $3 million. Like, it's seriously that simple. Do a little bit of research, understand what you're investing in, and save $400 a month and just stay disciplined. And you will have $3 million in 20 years or 30 years. So play around with the compound calculator. It will open your eyes and maybe it'll make you stay. Like, that's what I do. Like, when I get a little off track or I want to get off track, I just open that compound calculator, put where I'm at now, what I do a month, and then it gets me right back on track. It just reminds me. So growth companies also, they could 2 to 10X. So like, I've never had a 10X stock yet, but I've had multiple companies that I've invested in that are already in the high 200% to 300%. So I'm already at 2, 3X potential, and the crazy part is, I don't even want to sell these guys like anytime soon. So they could potentially 10X in the next couple of years. Very possible. So that's really where you want to do. You want to do, well, I like growth companies, and that's the videos I make primarily on stocks I'm buying, what percentage I'm buying of my portfolio of that stock. So it's another reason to subscribe if you kind of want guidance a little bit. Obviously do your own research before you buy something, but I basically say exactly what I do. So, what the heck is that word? I don't know what I just said there, so we're gonna skip that. But the more you invest, the more confident you'll be. So if you're new to the market or you're, 1-2 years in, you might, dive around with maybe 100, 200 bucks. And, obviously just like anything else, the more you do it, the more confident you get. It's just like practice in anything. You could do it to a sport or you could relate it to really anything. But really, the more you do it, the more confident you get. The more confident you get, the more money you're willing to put in that, market. And you just feel better doing it. You're not scared. So I remember when I first started a couple of years ago, I was very hesitant to put any of my money in here. So I'm like, why am I taking my hard-earned money and risking it in something I don't know what's going to happen? Well, that's because I wasn't educated enough and didn't do enough research on the companies I'm buying. Once you see how it works and once you feel, it's just like anything else. I mean, it's just like practice. So the more and more you do it, the more confident you get, the more confident you get, the more money you'll put in there, and then you obviously compound your wealth quicker. Same principle to any sport you played maybe growing up. So obviously you don't also want to panic sell. I know a lot of new people in the market in the past year, especially, they've been throwing money in anything and it's been going up. So obviously you look like a genius. You think, oh my God, I just put money in the market and it's going to, 10X or 2X or whatever. It doesn't go down ever. Well, that's not true. That's actually not even a healthy market if you really want to go on that angle. You really want volatility. You want corrections. You want, normal evaluations. Like everything right now, especially in the growth sector, most things are overvalued, to be honest. So you got to be very, very, very careful what you buy, and especially right now. So there are some good deals out there. I have been buying some stocks. If you watch my previous videos, I've been buying stuff at least once a week, so there's still some good deals out there, obviously. But yeah, don't panic sell. If it goes down, just look at it as a buying opportunity. So that's another thing you need to get drilled in your mind, whereas if you buy a good company, well, if it goes down, just buy more. Don't panic and say, oh my God, I lost, 10% of my money. This is stupid. I'm done. Like that's not a good way of looking at things. So yeah, that's really my thoughts on don't cash out too soon. And I feel like all these reasons, like if you do it, you're in it for the wrong reasons, in my opinion, especially if you're a long-term investor. Now, if you're day trading, swing trading, option trading, like I really can't talk too much on behalf of that stuff because I don't really practice it. I've tried it. I've had horrible luck with it. Maybe that's why I'm very against it. I tried doing both, and I think really what you got to do is you got to put your focus on one thing, just like anything in life. You can't be an expert at everything in life or every segment something. You really got to key in on what you want to be good at and what you think is the best thing for you. So for me, growth stocks, long-term investing, individual stock picking. That's what I enjoy doing. That's what I feel like has the best return and minimal risk, in my opinion. So that's all I got. If you like this video, make sure you like, subscribe, comment below. I will have some more content out this week on stocks I'm potentially buying. I did in yesterday's video say stocks I am watching this week. So if you want to check that out, see what stocks I'm looking at this week, it's one video back. So that's all I got. Peace.